We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Okay, so we are at here in this slide, last slide, right? Everybody are seeing my slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, do you have any doubt in this thing, connection object? Okay, now the another topic is using background threads. Okay, service topic is completed, but we are discussing that how we can write the background threads. Again, you see that in a service that will execute in background. Okay, so we are now going to discuss that how gently or the effectively we can write the background task. Okay, so that we need to discuss right here. So mainly what happen when you execute any application, their UI will execute in main thread, right? So if you need some long running tasks that need to be scheduled in background, right? So it depends the responsiveness of your application, that how you are writing your application that serve the perfect combination of background and the foreground task. So in a background, we will do the data processing and all other network lookups and all other things. So that should be scheduled in child thread, right? And all UI that need to be executed on main thread. So here we will utilize the async task to do this thing. Basically, you have already learned that how threading will work. Right, so you can execute the different threads of a one process and then you can synchronize it in thread mechanism. That can be possible in Android, but to deal with this thing perfectly, we can employ the async task. Async task is very useful when you write the network lookups. That means to download JSONs, or you can say the XML file or the web services from web that you can utilize, right? But nowadays there are so many libraries are available, so developer are not writing code with the help of async task. But if you see our syllabus, we does not have that libraries in syllabus like Wally or the Retrofit or the Jackson or the JSON, right? These are the libraries are available to fire your asynchronous query on web as well as to process the JSON and XML. We already learned JSON parsing and XML parsing, but how to send async request on web server, that we need to discuss. So this is the first topic, that how we can schedule that requesting of that network resource on web. So that we are discussing right here, that is async task. Async means what? Asynchronous task. Right, two types of tasks are there, either it is synchronous or the asynchronous. In synchronous, what happened? They are synchronized in a proper sequence and one by one it will execute. So it will create the block, right? Until a one task is completed, another task cannot be executed. So same way, if you utilize the async task parallelly, right, when your UI is on foreground, in a background scene your task is executed that will do the database processing, or say that from the network you are downloading information and all other things, right? So async task will do all the tasks that is related for the thread creation, thread management, it's synchronizing of all these things and processing this one. But if you compare async task with the services, right, async task are the short-lived background processing, but the services is the long-lived background processing. Like say that if you want to retrieve record from the MySQL database, right, so you can write that particular query or the request in async task. But if you need to write that the update the UI according to the number of message that arrive in Facebook or the WhatsApp, that can be written in services. If you want to play the music, that can be handled with the services component. But a short task, right, that you want to write, then we can utilize async task. And as I said, right, nowadays everybody are using the Volley and Retrofit kind of libraries. But let's see that if you good enough to write async task, right, it always help you to work with that Retrofit and Volley. And if anybody from you have worked with Volley, you can just compare these methods to the Volley. Almost similar, right? Almost 60 to 70% relevant things are there with the Volley. But technically, and the logic behind Volley and async task is totally different, right? It will provide caching and faster speed and all other benefits that is available on those libraries. But in our syllabus, we have this thing async task, so we are discussing right here. Just see the skeleton of that async task is right there. So we are creating my asynchronous task, a class that is extended from async task, and just see that three parameters we have passed. Now according to your need, you can pass these three parameters. Now for your information, or that how these parameters are used within that method that I am explaining right here. Just see that first string parameter is there. So in doing background, that string parameters that we are utilizing. So basically you can pass, right, that first parameter that will utilize over there, and the integer one, just see that we are utilizing here in on progress update. And finally, we are publishing result on post execute. I have explained all this thing in detail for the theoretical way in my next slide, but I am explaining right here in skeleton, so it would be easy for you to write your code. So three basic methods are there do in background. That means whatever the task you want to perform in background or in a child tab, all those statements you need to write here. But always remember, right, in doing background, you cannot directly connect with your UI. If you try to update your UI, your async task with clause. Okay, to pass the progress value, or you, like say that we have one progress bar, right? Horizontal progress bar dialog box, or the progress bar we have placed on screen, and we want to update this thing, right? So according to the background data we have processed, we need to update it. So for those kind of purpose, Android provide one method, that is the publish progress, where you can pass the values that you want to update on your UI side. So whenever you call that publish progress method, it will invoke on progress update method, right? So on progress update method, that will synchronize your code to the UI main thread. So what happened? Background thread and the main thread can be synchronized, right? So at that time, you can create the notification bar or the update the progress bar, or if you wish to update any UI, that is feasible in on progress update. But don't dare to write this kind of code directly within doing background thread. Otherwise, your application is going to be crashed. Then finally, if your task is completed 100% in background, whatever the statement you have written in doing background, it is completed. then another method will execute, that is the last one, that is on post execute. It name itself says on post execute. That means after completing your process, that will execute. So here what happened, again you have a reference of the UI, so you can sync your code with the UI main thread and you can report the result or the update, the dialogue or the notification or progress or anything, whatever you want to report towards your users, that is possible. So these three methods are main right here: doing background, on progress update, and on post execute. Okay, whatever I have explained, that I have written theoretically for your reference, that you can write in your GTU paper. So I'm just omitting this line. Do you have any doubt in this thing?
No, sir.
Okay. This is actually most important thing, right? When we meet in college, right? I will just give you this example that how you can write. And don't afraid, this topic will never ask in practical examination, right? Till now, last 10 years, they have never asked this thing. So I can give you this kind of confidence that this kind of question cannot ask in your practical exam. But of course, in a theory exam, they can ask. Now, another thing, right? How you can run that async task? Now you cannot directly call any method like doing background or on progress or the on execute update by creating the instance of my async task. Usually what happened, right? We are creating class, then create the object of it, and object.method can be called. But in the case of async task, you can't do these kind of things, right? So just see that how we can call. Just see right here, our last line, what we have created with the help of anonymous reference, or if you wish, you can create the object, but execute method, right? You need to utilize the execute method where you can pass your input, right? Or the string from where, which URL you want to download the data, or the anything, any parameter you want to pass with the async task. So just see, it's an execute method. And if you see, we does not define any execute method in async task. So always remember, right? You can't directly call doing background, on progress update, or on post execute with the help of async task object, but you need to utilize which thing? Execute method. Object of my async task dot execute, and your parameter need to be passed. This is a tricky thing, right? So it may be ask in your fill in the blanks or a 1 or 2 mark question. Is it clear? Please confirm.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, another thing, that's a alarm services. How you can utilize the alarm services? So we know what is alarm, right? I don't feel any need that I introduce what is alarm. But I want to define the difference between the timer and alarm. We have already learned the timer control. Which timer control we have learned? Can anybody say? We have already learned one UI control that do the task of timer. I'm waiting for your answers. Hello. Time tick event, any event at the Kaisakse koi skew to Kesar have a bow gulai you format lagi you with the online to Jonah gave a lagia. क्रोनोमीटर कही है ने एक ऑब्जेक्ट तो है ना टाइमर तरीके आपने यूज करता ओके सो व्हाट हैपन विद दिस टाइमर दे हैव द स्कोप लिमिटेड टू द एप्लीकेशन राइट वंस यू क्लोज द एप्लीकेशन दैट टाइमर डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट बट इन द केस ऑफ अलार्म इफ एप्लीकेशन क्लोज right, that is running in background, because that's a background services, right? So alarm manager that you can utilize to trigger the certain event on specific time interval, right? તમે એક બર્થડે રિમાઇન્ડર રાખ્યું હોય કે ભાઈ નેક્સ્ટ યર આ ડેટ અને ટાઈમે તમારે અલાર્મ ઇવેન્ટ છે જનરેટ થવું જોઈએ, ધેન ઇટ વિલ પરફેક્ટલી ડન ઓન ધેટ થિંગ. ઓર તમારે ટાઈમ ઇન્ટરવલ રાખ્યું હોય કે એવરી ડે રાઈટ આ ટાઈમે આ વસ્તુ વિશે ઇન્વોક થવી જોઈએ, ધેન ઇટ ઇઝ પોસિબલ, રાઈટ? સો ધેટ કાઇન્ડ ઓફ ટાસ્ક ધેટ યુ કેન ડુ વિથ ધી અલાર્મ મેનેજર, એન્ડ યુ કેન યુટિલાઇઝ ધી અલાર્મ મેનેજર વિથ ધી બ્રોડકાસ્ટ ઇન્ટેન્ટ ઓર ધી બ્રોડકાસ્ટ રિસીવર્સ. ઓકે, so let's start the alarm manager. They have the four types of alarm: RTC backup, RTC ellipse real time, and ellipse real time backup. So what are the difference between these thing? Let's see quickly. RTC, what is the full form of RTC? Real time clock, right? I am not waiting because I am just running out of time right now, but I want to conclude this particular topic. That's why I am just taking this thing. We have very few slide in this particular topic. Should I complete this thing in this current lecture or the next lecture? Digest thase to atyare complete kariye nahitar pachi next ma. બહુ ઇઝી છે, રાઈટ? સો ફર્સ્ટ થિંગ, આરટીસી વેકઅપ, રિયલ ટાઈમ ક્લોક, રાઈટ? સો વોટ હેપન, વેકઅપ મીન્સ વોટ? ઇટ વિલ awake your device from sleep. When alarm is happen, your device will wake up, right? So you can see that screen. Okay, another thing, that RTC only, that fire the pending intent at the time specified, but your device will not wake up. Another thing, ellipse real time. Now it is different from the above two, because it will consider time that is elapsed from your device is boot up. It will not directly take the date and time of your device, but it considered the millisecond from the boot up time, right? So the time ellipse include any period of time that is device was asleep, right? So that will get the difference between this thing, and then you can execute this one. Another one, ellipse real time wake up. So in a previous case, your device device will not wake up, but in this case it will work exactly, but your device will wake up, right? So wake up the device from asleep and fire the pending intent after the specified length of time has passed since your device is boot, right? So in first two, it will directly work on calendar date and time, and last two one, that will started according to the boot time. Okay, now just see that we are creating the alarm. A code yaad rakhjo, our same code last slide ni andar ek slide pachi aavse, khali ek j line che change thase, etle tyare hu tamne last bold thayeli line che ne e j hu alag thi explain karish. Okay, so how we can write the alarm manager? So just see, alarm manager equal to alarm manager dot get system service, right? We are writing this thing for the many services, like said that layout infiltrator and all other thing. So right now we are just referring the alarm services. So let's utilize that alarm services by casting it, and we get the alarm manager. Now we set the ellipse real time backup, the fourth flag that we have set, right? So it will execute on certain amount of time. So amount of time that we need to specify in milliseconds. So just see that long time or length of wait that we are specifying. So it's a 10,000 milliseconds. So it become 10 seconds. 1,000 milliseconds means 1 second. Now we are creating one intent right here. Just see, it's a pending intent. When that time happens, that pending intent will trigger. So just see, pending intent, alarm intent, equal to pending intent dot get broadcast, where we are passing total four parameter. This, that is the current context, zero, that's a request code, intent to fire, so that intent we have created above it, that is alarm action, right? Whatever the alarm action we want to trigger, that we are specifying as the action. And the last one, that's a flag, right? It's private to this one, that either we want to create it if it is not there, so that's why we are specifying zero. So alarm manager dot set, all four things that we are going to specify it right here, that alarm type first one. So type is ellipse real time wake up. Another thing, time or length, right? So 10 second that we have specified, and which pending intent we need to execute, that's a alarm intent we have specified. So when you utilize this code, what happened after 10 second, your pending intent will fire. Just see, in this intent we have not written anything, but when we meet, right, we will write one GTO example. At that time it will play a certain sound, or it will just give you the task message, because at that time we will bind the broadcast receiver over there. Okay, if you want to cancel it, samjho ki ek var ringtone vaigi ane tamara ene close karu, so you have one button, when you click on that, your alarm is canceled. So alarm manager dot cancel method is there, and you need to pass the object of that pending intent that we have created, alarm intent, right? So that will cancel the your triggered alarm. Now how you can make it repeat? Set repeat, that is that you can difference that you want to repeat your alarm, or it is the one shot alarm, right? So in a set repeating, you can specify the exact interval of time that is going to be repeated. તમે જે ટાઈમ સ્પેસિફાય કરશો એટલા ટાઈમે, 10 સેકન્ડ છે, 15 સેકન્ડ છે, 1 કલાક છે, એટલા ટાઈમ પછી એ રિપીટ થશે. એન્ડ અનધર થિંગ ઇઝ ધેટ સેટ ઇન એક્ઝેક્ટ રિપીટિંગ ટાઈમ. સો વેર સમ ઓફ ધી કોન્સ્ટન્ટ્સ ધેટ ઇઝ સ્પેસિફાઈડ બાય એન્ડ્રોઇડ સિસ્ટમ, ધેટ આફ્ટર ધેટ ઇન્ટરવલ ધેટ વિલ રિપીટ, રાઈટ? સો ઇટ ઇઝ નોન એઝ ઇન એક્ઝેક્ટ રિપીટિંગ ટાઈમ. એન્ડ ઇફ યુ આર યુઝિંગ ધીસ કોન્સ્ટન્ટ, રાઈટ, ઇટ વિલ just optimize the battery uses, right? So it will reduce the battery drain efficiently, because they have already calculated constants are there. But in repeating, whenever you are specifying the custom interval, they need to compare both epoch time, and then they will set to this thing. So on each time slot, or the on each time tick, that calculation need to be redone, right? So in exit is always a good choice. So just see which type of constant we have. So see, there are 5 to 6 constant we have: interval, 15 minutes, half an hour, hour, half day, and day. So they have fixed time slot they have created in constant that you can pass in set in exit repeating time, and your alarm will be repeated on that thing. એના પ્રીવિયસમાં જે રિપીટિંગ હતું, અહીંયા તમારે કસ્ટમ આપવું પડે, 10 સેકન્ડ, 15 સેકન્ડ, એક દિવસ, રાઈટ? તો સેકન્ડ્સની અંદર તમારે સ્પેસિફાઈ કરવું પડે, પણ અહીંયા કોન્સ્ટન્ટ હશે. સો કેલ્ક્યુલેશન ઇઝ ઓલરેડી ડન, ઇટ વિલ જસ્ટ એડ ઇન ટુ ધી પ્રીવિયસ સ્લોટ એન્ડ વિલ ક્રિએટ ધી નેક્સ્ટ વન. સો હાઉ યુ કેન ક્રિએટ ધેટ ઇન એક્ઝેક્ટ ટાઈમ, દેટ વી નીડ ટુ સી. સો જસ્ટ સી ધેટ એન્ટાયર કોડ ઇઝ સેમ, બટ લાસ્ટ લાઈન, રાઈટ, લાસ્ટ લાઈન ઇઝ ચેન્જ. જસ્ટ સી ધી પ્રીવિયસ કોડ, એઝ આઈ હેવ શોન, alarm manager dot set is there, but right here we are setting it for the repeat. So you see, alarm manager dot set in exit repeat, where we pass the alarm type, right? Alarm type, just see that that is ellipse real time. But another thing you can not write here, that is the long time or length, where we are just specifying that interval half hour, right? So on each half hour, this alarm will exit, right? So that parameter we are specified at the second, and time or length of the wait that we are specifying right here. Okay, આ બે વાર રિપીટ છે, મારાથી છે થઈ ગયું છે. એન્ડ ધ લાસ્ટ વન, એક રોંગ તમારે શું આવશે, અહીંયા એક જ આવશે. અને અલાર્મ ઇન્ટેન્ડ જે છે એ આપણે સ્પેસિફાઈ કરીએ છીએ કે જે સ્ટાર્ટ થવો જોઈએ. ઓકે, સો અહીંયા શું થશે, એવરી હાફ અવર ધેટ અલાર્મ વિલ એક્ઝિક્યુટ, રિમેનિંગ ઓલ કોડ આર સેમ ધેટ વી હેવ પ્રીવિયસલી ડિસ્કસ. સો આઈ એમ નોટ રીડિંગ એન્ટાયર સ્લાઇડ અગેન એન્ડ અગેન. ઓકે, સો હાઉ વી કેન એમ્પ્લોય ઓર ક્રિએટ ધી રિપીટિંગ અલાર્મ વિથ ધી હેલ્પ ઓફ સેટ ઇન એક્ઝેક્ટ રિપીટિંગ ટેપ. ઓકે, સો ધેટ્સ ઓલ ફ્રોમ ધીસ ચેપ્ટર, ચેપ્ટર નંબર 9. And right here, our unit number 3 is completed. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So, we will start new unit in next lecture. So, thank you for now. If you have any doubt, you can ask or you can call it or just arrange the private meeting on this Zoom. I will explain you in detail. Do you have any doubt?
No.
Okay. Bye.
Thanks a lot.